You're listening to The Alex Jones Show. Big Brother, mainstream media, government cover-ups. You want answers? Well, so does he. He's Alex Jones on the GCN Radio Network.
And now.
And now, live from Austin, Texas, Alex Jones.
All right, let's go right back to Lionel. He's with us till 20 after. We're taking your phone calls. Before he leaves us, he'll give us his take on Selma. I've not seen it yet. I think Martin Luther King did a lot of great things. That said, I've read the cheat sheet on it, and it's being brought out at this point, this time, to further exacerbate racial tensions, all part of the George Soros backdrop. That's my view. I don't know Lionel's view on it. I know he wants to review it, so we'll get his take on that in the next segment. Right now, Howard in Illinois, thank you for holding. You're on the air worldwide.
Hey, Alex and Lionel.
Welcome.
Thank you.
Well, thank you, brother.
I just wanted to talk to you a minute about the InfoWars Freedoms of America pamphlet. Do you know about that?
No. I mean, I know that we put a free citizen rule book in all orders. It's got the Declaration of Independence, Constitution, famous quotes, stuff like that. What are you talking about?
Well, I'm talking about this pamphlet you should come out with that would have the top 10 things that the government's lying to us about, like Obamacare, gun control.
Please, you know, that's a great idea, like a simple 20, 30-page pamphlet that's inexpensive, that folks can buy at cost, that just has the big lies and then solutions and then some websites that have educational videos on them. That would be great to hand out to people.
Well, if you print them up, I'll order 100 and I'll hand them out to 100 of my friends and strangers both.
Yeah, I would fashion them almost after chick tracks. Maybe even have some cartoons or illustrations in it as well. I want to do it. It's on the back burner. I've meant to do it for years. But yes, sir, we should do that.
Also, maybe some pamphlets for the police, for us to hand to the police and say, hey, we're not in a war with you.
Now, that's a great idea to boil down the globalist plan. And the cops really click to it because they're already in it. They're somewhat decompartmentalized because they already have inside scoops on a lot of stuff, and they want the next level of decompartmentalization. Then when they get our intel, go check for themselves and find out it's true. Our credibility just goes up, 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 up. That's a problem the establishment has because we have penetrated the compartmentalization of the military and police. I mean, they are the easiest to wake up, a natural ally to freedom, if we'll just stop hating them and reach out to them. That doesn't mean they're all going to want to be woken up just like the general public. But statistically, I've seen it and I've experienced it. I think I get chills talking about it. We can really beat the globalist. We've just got to believe we can do it. Lionel, any comments on what Howard's saying?
Well, my comment would be to have the top 10 things that the government is lying about, you need the top 1,000, because the idea of that would be a rather daunting cause. You know, Alex, you mentioned something before about global warming. Global warming and global and climate change is a religion. Nobody has any idea of the second part about that. Because what I tell people, and just going back to what you said, I will concede, I will stipulate to global change, global warming. I don't really care about that. What about the carbon trading part? What about the carbon taxing part? What about the Maurice Strong, Al Gore contingent? And you get the look of, what are you talking about? Because the issue is critical thinking says, I'm not arguing about this, just like I'm not arguing about whether we should honor the military. I'm not arguing whether we respect the police. When I talk about a particular aspect of a huge subject matter,
they're doing the same thing. They're saying, do not question or we're going to arrest you in Europe. This is a religion. Everyone agrees. Man-made global warming, pay Al Gore money. Well, no, not everyone agrees. And it's been proven to be a fraud that man is a huge contributor. It's the sun.
And also, if you look at how ice caps are melting on Mars and others, Alex, I have friends of mine who have taken it upon for you to even challenge the proposition that maybe this might be a tad exaggerated. It's like me challenging their mother's chastity or their religion or their faith in something. And what they'll do is, Alex, they'll always say this. How can you tell me that all of these scientists, all of these, and I'm saying, what scientists? And they have a kind of an idea about that.
Exactly. Look. Stay there. We're going to come back with calls.
The government's Department of Homeland Security is buying up loads of ammo. At the same time, they're restricting civilians' rights to own and purchase firearms. Can you put two and two together? Infidel body armor can stop every round, including hollow points and 308 sniper rounds, is reasonably priced and fully legal. But for how long? Go to InfidelBodyArmor.com, spelled I-N-F-I-D-E-L, BodyArmor.com. Infidel Body Armor. Just won't quit.
When cells become toxic, they die early and aging sets in. No one has put together a formula that focuses directly on brain health, nerve growth factors, and optimizing your cellular energy at the same time. Just one of the key compounds, BioPQQ, is backed by major clinical studies. You want the best that's out there at the lowest price anywhere? We now have the synergistic solution. Secure your DNA force today at InfoWarsLife.com or call toll-free 888-253-3139. Sold out for weeks due to the difficult and extensive proprietary process behind its creation, the exclusive InfoWars Life Secret 12 formulation is now back in stock. This ultra-clean vitamin B12 nutraceutical has been carefully crafted and developed over the last 2 years and is based on cellular science of how your body actively absorbs essential nutrients. Most forms of vitamin B12 are highly processed and synthetic and could not be properly absorbed by the body. Secret 12 is a binary of nutraceutical grade, bioavailable coenzyme forms of B12, methylcobalamin, the same kind used in B12 injections, and adenosylcobalamin, the most bioactive form that has been created with our proprietary process. Secret 12 is taken by mouth, right on the tongue, and then swallowed. No needles, no injections. Don't take my word for it. Try it for yourself. Discover the secret. Secret 12. Supplies of Secret 12 are very limited. Secure yours today at InfoWarsLife.com or by calling toll-free 888-253-3139. The knowledge of the ancients, tried and true, trusted herbs and extracts fused with the latest nutraceutical science. Introducing the all-new Ancient Defense Herbal Immunity Blend, crafted with over 14 key ancient herbs and extracts to supercharge and prepare your body for what experts admit is the most dangerous season of the year. We have rejected hundreds of other formulations in our quest to bring you what is simply the most powerful and comprehensive proprietary formula that we have ever created in the realm of herbal immunity. For the last 2 years, our team has been working with top doctors, nutritionists, and chemists to develop the ultimate nutraceutical formulation. Experience the benefits of combining over 14 ancient herbs and extracts with exciting new advances in nutraceutical science. For a limited time, get 25% off on this introductory offer. Visit AncientDefense.com or call 888-253-3139. AncientDefense.com.
Defending the Republic from enemies, foreign and domestic, it's Alex Jones.
The system says don't question the military or police. Then the system takes over the military and police at the highest levels to turn them into instruments of the globalist takeover. Then they try to turn us against the police at the low level to start a war. It's a very simple equation of divide and conquer and destabilization. Same thing they've been saying for 20 years. Man-made global warming is real. It's going to kill everybody unless we have a global government and regulate and surveil all human activity and tax humans for the carbon dioxide that they exhale. That's a New York Times headline, a tax on breathing. It's now here. The taxes are going in California. The taxes have devastated Australia. Now they're trying to implement outside of Congress passing a law. We've got Mark Moreno of Climate Depot popping in at the bottom of the hour to talk about the shock vote on the surface in the Senate, where 98-1, there was one abstention, one person wasn't there, 98-1 out of 100 senators voted that climate change is real. But notice, Senator Inhofe said, well, I had to vote because it was up for a vote. I have his quotes here. They played a trick where, of course, we agree that there's climate change. The climate's always changing. So we had a vote and had to vote, but it's a scam because it didn't say man-made climate change. Mark Moreno was his former chief of staff and advisor. So we've got Mark Moreno joining us, formerly worked for Senator Inhofe and advised the Senate climatedepot.com. He's going to be joining us to talk about this. But sure enough, this morning, I knew it driving in. I said, let me just see. And I dialed around on AM. They weren't talking about it. Went over to NPR. And they must be saying it every 10 minutes. Well, the Senate voted 98-1. The Republicans admit climate change is real. We need to do something about it. That was the lie. And they're going to just sit there and tell their idiot listeners, see, all scientists agree, and even all the senators, but one kook from Louisiana, you know those dummies in the South. Yeah, that's just the way it is. I want to go to Riley and others. We've got to go to calls quick here, but you were getting into that, Lionel, media analyst. I'm moving too quick here. Then I also want to get into your review of Selma, but go ahead.
Well, you made a couple of things. You know, Alex, you and I realize the importance of language. And I don't want to overplay this, but when President Obama was running, he said, hope and change. I want change. I want change. I want change. And I, at the time, was with a group of friends, and I said, do you mean change or improvement? And they thought I was being a bit callous about this. If I said, Mr. Jones, your tumor has changed, you wouldn't say, all right, thank you, doc. You would say, whoa, 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 what do you mean change? Has it improved? Has it gotten better? Climate change. Now, I'm not in any way trying to belabor the point here, but even the term leaves itself for wiggle room. And I got to say this one thing, Alex, just because memes build up a momentum, myths and the like. Let's take Hollywood. People were saying about Selma, Hollywood is racist. And so-and-so and this particular leader is going to go to Hollywood and sit down and talk to these people. By the way, the same people who hated conspiracy theories thought absolutely that the Sony hack was an inside job. It's funny how the concept of conspiracies are not a problem. So we're going to go to Hollywood. We're going to say, hey, how come Selma, how come you're a racist? How come you did this? And Hollywood turns around and says, last year, 12 years a slave, it won every award there was. Oh, well, that's different. Well, Hollywood's liberal. Wait a minute. This year, American Sniper. Supposedly, Hollywood hates Clint Eastwood, hates shoot 'em ups, hates war propaganda. Hollywood loves this. You see, Alex, people will just make up whatever they want to say so that their worldview fits into it.
Exactly, and we don't do that. We get accused of being conspiracy theorists, where I really try to look at each case, study it, and come up with what is the most common sense, accurate analysis. But when you look at Hollywood, it's just whatever agenda they want, and it's clearly propaganda. Let's go.
Yes, sir.
And then when Selma doesn't get enough nominations, it's racist as well. I mean, it's ridiculous. Let's go to Riley in Iowa. Thank you for holding. Go ahead.
Hey, good to be on with you guys.
Good to have you.
Just a quick comment, and then let's talk about the driving force of propaganda. It was sort of revealed to me watching that Mike Dice video on MLK. But a quick comment, climate and weather is defined as long-term patterns or change. So the topic of climate change seems pretty redundant to me because it's built into the
definition.
Because
weather changes. Yeah, first it's global freezing, then global warming man-made, anthropogenic. Then when that's disproven, they just go change. Change. I mean, soon yeah. They'll teach that there were never cycles or never seasons.
Yeah, so let's move on there because that's kind of redundant, so I don't want to spend time there. But I posted on my blog. It's Upright Riley. You can find it on Facebook, yada, yada. But it's based on Mark Dice's video that you posted. The blog is focused on the driving force of propaganda, which is suggestibility. The people in the video were only suggested that MLK was going to be put on Mount Rushmore, and they were just sucked into the lie only because it was suggested. And here's the
show. No, that's right. They just want to comply. So Martin Luther King died today, and he was the first black man to walk on the moon, and he was a Confederate general. And the people are there agreeing, going, oh, yes, that's wonderful. I'm glad he's a Confederate general. It just shows they're zombies. They're in a trance state, highly suggestible, being raised on television. That's the paradigm. You just hit it.
Well, you know, Alex, yeah, if I could add something. I'm sorry.
What, next, Lionel? You don't believe he was the first black man to walk on the moon? What's wrong with that? Let's honor black people and build them up. What, you don't think we can have black doctors and black astronauts? Why are you now being racist against Martin Luther King? He was the first man to walk on the moon. See how that works? Don't you dare say Chris Kyle wasn't who they said he was.
You know, one of the best things, Alex, I thought, going back about how a meme, you know, remember, if ever you're killed or shot by the police, you better say something pithy that somebody can put in a hashtag on their hand or else you're not going to get a movement. If you say, oh, blank, when you're shot, guess what? You're out of luck. When Charlie Hebdo came up, And the people that I know were holding up pencils.